So I'm going to talk to you today through steps in the journey of modernizing a public sector SOC or a security operations center. So what is a public sector SOC? So a security operations center in a public sector environment integrates people, processes, and technology to prevent, detect, respond, and recover from cyber incidents against a public sector's organization's digital ecosystem. Now, a public sector also often has the responsibility of monitoring regulatory compliance specific to that country as it relates to the SOC. So a SOC should have technology that enables how to leverage new modern capabilities like hyperscale cloud advances, AI and automation to level that playing field like we talked about, right? How people should be organized to align to modern security service management practices in a hyperscale cloud environment, which is different than an on-premise SOC. And then how operational processes should be updated to reflect the changes in technology and people's roles and responsibilities in a modern SOC. So let's dive into what a modern SOC modernization journey should look like for public sector organizations. So this could be divided into three different phases, right? Envisioning, implementation, and then operationalization of that SOC. So let's start with the first phase, envisioning. This phase is all about preparing for your modernization journey. First thing that we need to do is define the vision and strategy. The vision outlines what you want to do and why you want to do it. And the strategy is how to go about achieving your vision. An example of a vision would be something like, we need to modernize our government security operations center to improve our cyber resilience against advanced threats from nation states and cyber criminals. Your strategy should define how you will implement your vision. So to create your strategy, you'll need to understand things like, what is the technology that can be used to help me modernize? Do I need a service provider to help me guide me through the implementation? Do I need help operating my new environment? Maybe I need a service provider to manage the environment for me. Do I need organizational realignment in how my SOC is organized? Do I need to retrain or scale my staff? As you work to define your strategy, it's important to keep in mind that you aren't just modernizing the technology, but modernizing your security organization as a whole, right? This includes the modernization of processes and the operationalization of this new SOC. Once you have your vision and strategy mapped out, do you then have to create a mission? Now, your mission focuses on the key objectives and how to measure those objectives, right? So it should go much deeper and more detailed than your vision. For example, you can say, I'm going to use hyperscale cloud automation to improve the time to detect and remediate incidents from 8 hours to 2 hours, for example. So that could be an example of a clear mission and objective that you may have. Now, when we talk about policy, it's important to create a policy that clearly defines what is the mandate for the agency SOC, right? So the policy determines that mandate. For example, we can say the agency SOC just handles the low severity security incidents and escalates more complex severity incidents to a national cybersecurity center, right? So these all needs to be defined and outlined in your policy, as this will determine how you operate that SOC. Next part of our journey is performing a current assessment of your security operations, right? So in a current SOC assessment, you'll be able to determine where you are at in the SOC modernization maturity spectrum, the steps that you need to do to get there into that optimized environment, right? And you have to have a North Star that you have as an aim to get to. And so that whole spectrum allows you to then determine the steps that you need to do. Now, depending on where you are and the country or the region that you're in, you sometimes have to do what we call an ATO or an authority to operate or cloud accreditation. And what this means is that you are looking to see how hypercloud technology for your SOC maps to specific regulations that a particular government may have, like NIS2 or FedRAMP or PBMM or NHS and so on and so forth. And the last step in our envisioning phase is the creation of a roadmap. And in this modernization roadmap, you're going to detail the exact steps you need to complete, when, who's going to do it, and how it's going to be done. Now we move on to the phase two, which is the implementation. In that implementation, you're going to have to start working towards the technology planning and design and the enablement of that technology and the elements of that technology for your SOC. And then you're going to focus on the integration of the data sources that are going to be feeding that particular SOC. In the third and final phase is operate. This is where you have a live environment and you start utilizing your new modernized security operations center. This may mean turning over the keys of the operations center to a security service provider that will manage it for you, or to the team responsible for that SOC within your organization. Now, there's a couple of key actions that you need to take during the phase of operationalization to make sure you have smooth operations, right? First one is creation of a RACI. Who's going to be responsible, accountable, consulted, and informed, right? Roles and responsibilities. Then you need to document and or update your security runbooks to reflect the fact that now you're using new tools and new technologies, and you need to define when there's a security incident, what are the series of tasks and the workflows that I need to execute, and by whom, and using what tools to be able to address a particular incident that comes into the SOC, right? And then lastly, you need to measure and continuously optimize, right? So just because you have that modern security SOC doesn't mean the journey ends, right? It means that you need to continuously monitor, fine-tune, and continue to find ways to optimize your SOC going forward, because the cyber threats and the cyber attackers are always innovating. They're always optimizing themselves. So we have to keep pace with that as well. For more information on cybersecurity in the public sector, please visit aka.ms/public sector cybersecurity. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you found this video useful and informative.